हरि ओम। वी शैल चांट फ्रॉम वर्स नंबर 13। सर्वकर्माणि मनसा सन्यस्यास्ते सुखं वशी नवद्वारे पुरे देहि नैव कुर्वन्न कारयन् न कर्तृत्वं न कर्माणि लोकस्य सृजति प्रभुः न कर्मफलसंयोगम् स्वभावस्तु प्रवर्तते नादत्ते कस्यचित् पापम् न चैव सुकृतं विभुः अज्ञानेनावृतं ज्ञानम् तेन मुह्यन्ति जन्तवः ज्ञानेन तु तदज्ञानम् येषां नाशितमात्मनः तेषाम् आदित्यवज्ञानम् प्रकाशयति तत्परम् तद्बुद्धयस्तदात्मानः तन्निष्ठास्तत्परायणाः गच्छन्ति पुनरावृत्तिम् ज्ञाननिर्धूतकल्मषाः। सो फर्स्ट बाय फॉलोइंग द पाथ ऑफ Karma Yoga, one purifies the mind, the antakarana. Thereafter gains the knowledge of the self through Shravan and Manan. Then one gives up the notion of doership, which we had falsely assumed on ourselves. That itself is called karma sannyas, and then meditate on that self and realize that self. One who has recognized that self remains in this looking at this world, in this body, like the Prabhu. Naiva kurvan nakarayan, without doing anything and without propelling anything or anyone to do anything. Not propelling the senses or the mind to function. So that knowledge has to be acquired, and through that knowledge all the ajnana goes away. Because of ajnana only we have the notion of doership, enjoyership, knowership, kartrutva, bhoktrutva, nyatrutva, bhavana we have because of ajnana. So one who has gained this knowledge, for such a person, that knowledge destroys all ignorance and all everything. The truth gets revealed. So like the sun revealing the entire world. So tesham adityavad jnanam prakashayati tatparam. So once we gain that knowledge, one has to meditate on that self that is revealed here, ki tad buddhayah, tad atmanah, tan nishthah, tat parayanah. that having gained that knowledge, the buddhi has to be constantly diverted towards that self alone. What we have understood through our buddhi, one has to shift one's attention there constantly, so that buddhi also merges into that self. So tad buddhayaha, in that state of meditation, when we sit for meditation, the buddhi has to be constantly engaged in that self alone. What we have understood, all the thoughts should be diverted towards that self. It's called sajatiya vritti pravaha. Vritti, the thoughts, the flow of thoughts should be maintained towards that self alone. So tad buddhayaha, tad atmanaha. One who considers that tat, that Brahma alone as atma, tan nishthaha, one who has total abidance in that Brahma, tan nishtha, and tat parayanaha, one who considers that alone as the supreme goal, such a person attains that state of enlightenment, becomes realized, and such an enlightened person, a jivan mukta, remains in this body as long as the prarabdha of that body lasts. We have these three types of karma: sanchita karma, agami karma, and prarabdha karma. Sanchita is the stock of karmas which we have performed in all our past lives. Then agami is that which we perform in this life, which will give us result in future. And prarabdha is that karma because of which we have got this body and this particular life. So sanchita karma gets negated through knowledge. Agami karmas are not created through knowledge. But prarabdha karma, which has already started, will continue showing its effect. It's like the arrow which is shot through the bow. Once the arrow is shot, it will continue moving. Suppose you direct it towards a particular target and shoot it, but later on, after shooting, you come to know that, oh, that was the wrong place I have shot the arrow. But still the arrow will continue to go. Similarly, this body which we have got is because of our prarabdha. So the birth of the body, all that the body will experience in this life, and the death, all this is included in the prarabdha. So even when one gains knowledge, the body continues to exist. Therefore, the person will experience the body as well as the world. But once the body gets dropped, that jivan mukta is called videha mukta, he is not born again. Gacchanti apunaravrittim, there is no punaha avritti, there is no new addition. Avritti, we publish a book and then again we bring out a new edition. Like that, a person dies and is born again. It's like avritti in some other form. So this goes on and on. But a jivan mukta, when he dies, in the sense when the body is dropped, there is no more birth. Na punaravrittim. Jnana nirdhuta kalmashaha. Because through knowledge, all his jnana has got totally wiped out. There is no more cause for any birth. Again and again there is birth because there is cause. The vasanas are still there, karmas are still there, and one has to take birth again and again. But once through knowledge, all the vasanas and all the karmas get negated, there is no more birth. So, jnana nirdhuta kalmashaha. But while the body is there, the person seems to be living in this world, interacting with everyone, communicating. Therefore, Jivan Mukta is like a teacher who guides us, who shows us the path. So how does he live in this world? What are the characteristics of a Jivan Mukta? How does he see this world? That is indicated in the next verse, 18th verse. Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane Gavihastini Shunichaivashvapakecha Pandita Samadarshinaha Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Shunichaivashvapakecha Pandita Samadarshinaha Panditaha Pandita, those who have gained the knowledge of the self-realized person is called Pandit. It's plural of that Pandit, Panditaha. So this enlightened person, how do they look at this world? He says, Samadarshinaha, they see same everywhere. What same? In the next verse, Bhagavan will tell that Sama is Brahma, their own self. Outwardly, we see differences, but really speaking, the essence of everything is that same Brahma. So he sees the upadan, the very material, the very cause of this entire creation in all. He says, Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane, in a Brahman, in a Brahman who is Sattva Pradhan, who has got more of Sattva Gun, who is endowed with Vidya and Vinaya. Vidya means Atma Vidya only, one who knows the self. Maybe theoretically one may know the self, and one who is also endowed with humility, Vinaya. Vinaya also means upashamaha, whose mind has become very calm and peaceful. So a good person, and a knowledgeable person with all good qualities, in that person also this wise man sees the same Brahma. So it is easy to see Brahma, divinity, in a good person. But he also sees that same divinity in Gavi. Gavi means in a cow, holy cow, not so holy cow also. So in a cow, Gavi. Then Hastini, in an elephant. Elephant is more tamasic. So in elephant also, he sees the same divinity. Then Shuni, in a dog. Shuni. Cha eva shvapake cha. Shvapaka is a person who eats a dog. Dog eater. Shva in a dog. One who eats dog. Means one extremely tamasic person. One who is so tamasic that he doesn't even mind eating dog. Such person. In such a person also, Pandita Samadarshinaha, he sees the same Brahma in everyone. How does he see? See, when an ignorant person sees, with our eyes, we see the different bodies, human being, animal, bird, plant, of different gender, different class, different nationality. With our eyes, we see. And the eyes are showing the differences. the skin color is different, the dress people wear are different, everything is different. Then with our mind we can feel the person, or we can see something more with our mind. We can experience the emotions, we can experience the anger, the jealousies, the happiness, unhappiness also through our mind. Then with our intellect we can see something more. We can see our own nationality or some concept we can understand through our intellect. But all these are different only. But as far as that realized person is concerned, in all these different beings and in different class of beings, he sees the same truth. Samadarshinaha, not with his eyes, but with his understanding, with his realization. With his eyes he sees the same what we see. But with his understanding he knows that all this is that Brahma alone. See, just as let us say one that gold, and we make different types of ornaments. A person who only looks at the forms will see them as different. One form is different than the other. But one who has got the vision of gold, he will see the same gold in all. Or like we have this book, various letters and sentences and words are written. But if we keep our attention on the ink, we will be able to see the same ink everywhere. Whatever be the word, whatever be the sentence, good, bad, indifferent, we see the same ink everywhere. See, as far as interaction with any person is concerned, we interact with the body, we interact with the form, and we interact with the differences which are there. But the vision of a jnani is same everywhere. What does it mean? If he sees a cow and if he sees a tiger, he will have the same vision, that there is divinity in a cow and divinity in a tiger also. But when he has to interact, he will interact differently with a cow and differently with a tiger. Not that he will go and embrace the tiger. But he knows that same divinity is expressing as this tiger. Similarly, just like our books also, even though we might have the same vision towards all letters, all of them are ink, but we will consider some books as holy and some books as not holy. But the vision is same, that all of them are nothing but ink. To get that vision is not very simple. So slowly and steadily one attains this vision. See, as far as our looking at this world through our senses are concerned, whatever we see will be different from me only. If I am looking at this world, then whatever I am seeing is different from the seer. So as long as I have the vision that I am a seer, I will see everything as different from me. But through the help of the scriptures and through contemplation and deep meditation, when I come to know that the cause of this world, which is Brahma, and the self in me are not different, then I will be able to see everything with the same vision. I will know that though all are seem to be different outwardly, but everything is my own self. Atma va idagam sarvam. Vasudeva sarvamiti. That everything is that Vasudev. Sarvam khalvidam brahma. Everything is that Brahma. That vision the jnani acquires. This is a very important verse in another sense also, because many times we have all sorts of notions about spirituality. Many people think that once we gain enlightenment, the world will disappear, or some miraculous things might happen. Such things doesn't happen. The world will remain as it is. Only our vision will change. World remaining same, the vision will change. What we are seeing as differences, we will be able to see and understand the oneness in all. So the jnani will continue to see the world, continue to see a brahmana, a cow, an elephant, a dog, etc. But will know that the same reality is there in all of them. So vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane gavi hastini shunicheva shvapakecha pandita samadarshinaha. He has got the same vision. There is a very famous one shloka is there, which says that bhavadvaitam sada kuryat kriyadvaitam na karhi chet advaitam trishlokeshu na advaitam gurunasah. That one should have this vision of oneness, advaita, in our attitude, in our heart, that we should know that all of us are one. But as far as kriya is concerned, transaction is concerned, a transaction should not be equal towards everyone. Because transaction is done with the names and forms. So it cannot be same towards all. Transaction is different depending on the different forms and conditions and beings and all. So bhavadvaitam sada kuryat kriyad advaitam na karhi chet advaitam trishulokeshu na advaitam guruna sah. So we should have that vision of oneness everywhere. But when we meet our teacher, we should not think that, oh, you are also Brahma, I am also Brahman, I don't care for you. No, we should do namaskar. So in our kriya, we should have all the proper, follow all the rules and proper regulations. Now when it is said that this Atmajnani sees everyone with the same vision, there is one question which might come in our mind, because there is one Dharma Sutra which says that one should not treat people of same qualities differently, or we should not treat people of different qualities in the same way. There's a famous sutra from Gautam Smriti, ki sama samabhyam vishama same pujatah, that one should not worship or respect or treat people of different class in the same way. Then it becomes not proper. Not proper. For example, a very learned and very sattvic person is there, and another person not so totally tamasic and all, one should not treat them equally and respect them equally, worship them equally. Like that, there's some Dharma Sutra is there. Also, those who are unequal, those who are equal, should not be treated unequally. And this you must have experienced in our vyavhar, like in shadi mein vagere, wo bahut hota hai. Then people get annoyed also. Some people who think they are equal and all, if they are treated unequally, usko idhar ka seat de diya, unko upar ka de diya, to unko bahut isa, they feel very bad. And people of same level, if one is treated in a better way, another is totally sidelined, such things is considered improper on the part of the yajman, the one who is treating them. So here the question is, if the Atmajnani looks at all of them as divine, then isn't it a dosha? Isn't it something wrong that he is considering a brahmana, a cow, a hasti, a dog, and even a dog eater, he considers, looks at them with the same vision. So isn't it a dosha? Some defect, something improper. So Bhagavan says, no, it is not improper. Why it is not improper? He says in the next verse. Ihaevatarjita sargah yesham samye stitam manah nirdosham hi samam brahma tasmat brahmani te stitah ihaiva tairjita sargah yesham samye stitam manah. So this Dharma Sutra, which is mentioned, is meant for those people who have identification with this body, and because of this identification with the body, one sees different class, different grades, and depending on the different class of people, different grades and different types of situation, the Dharma Sutras, they have given guidance. You should treat, you should do it in this way, you should not do in this way, etc. But for an Atmajnani who has no identification with the body and who doesn't have the sense of doership and who is totally established in that Brahma which is equal in all, this sutra is not applicable for such a person. There is no dosha for him. So ihaiva, here itself, while living itself, Bhagavan says, ki taihi jitas sargaha, he has conquered, he has won over his life itself, his janma. Who yesham samme stitam manaha, whose mind, whose antakarana is established in that sama brahma. His mind is not on the body. His mind is not established in the divisions, in the separations, in all sorts of differences. But his mind is established in that Brahma, which is Saman everywhere. See, in our Purana, there is a story of Daksha Prajapati. Daksha Prajapati, father of Sati, when he became Prajapati, he became very proud and he threw a party. The story is there. So he called everyone for that party. But he did not call Lord Shiva because he had some, though he was his son-in-law, he did not call Lord Shiva. Nor did he call his daughter. And in that, not exactly party, but a special program where he had to invoke all the devatas and worship them and honor them, he did not invite Shiva, nor did he honor him. Which was totally wrong. And why he did like that? Because once, when all the little devatas were there, and when Daksha Prajapati had come to that place, Shiva was also there, and everyone got up and expressed their respect to him, but Shiva did not get up. So he was very annoyed. कि मेरा अपमान हो गया. ही डजंट नो हाउ ग्रेट आई एम. सो एज फार एज लॉर्ड शिवा इज कंसर्न, ही इज टोटली एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन दैट सुप्रीम सेल्फ. फॉर हिम ऑल आर इक्वल. बट द दक्ष प्रजापति वॉज लुकिंग फ्रॉम अनदर स्टैंड पॉइंट. ही हैड दिस आइडेंटिफिकेशन विथ हिज ओन बॉडी, सो ही वॉज लुकिंग फॉर फ्रॉम अ डिफरेंट स्टैंड पॉइंट. फॉर हिम देर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मान, अपमान एट्सेट्रा. बट फॉर वन हु इज एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन दैट सेल्फ, फॉर हिम एवरीथिंग इज दैट ब्रह्म. एंड दैट पर्सन बिकम्स फ्री फ्रॉम दिस मान एंड अपमान ऑल्सो. मानापमान तुल्य तुल्य निंदा स्तुतिर्मौनी. देर इज नो निंदा, नो स्तुति. ही इज बियॉन्ड ऑल दिस. सो भगवान सेज हिज माइंड इज एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन दैट साम्य. साम्य अवस्था, सेमनेस. इन सेमनेस मीन्स सेम इज वॉट, सेम इज ब्रह्म ओनली. इन सेवेंथ चैप्टर भगवान गिव्स एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ सूत्रे मणिगिणा इव. जस्ट लाइक दिस माला इज देयर द गार्लैंड. दो द फ्लावर्स आर ऑफ डिफरेंट शेप्स एंड ऑल डिफरेंट साइज, बट देर इज वन सूत्र, वन थ्रेड विच पासिस थ्रू ऑल ऑफ देम, एंड द थ्रेड इज कॉमन इन ऑल. सो वन हु हैज गॉट दैट विजन, वन हु नोज दैट थ्रेड, ही सीज दैट वननेस एवरीवेयर. With respect to thread, there is oneness. Similarly, with respect to Brahma, there is oneness in all. So his mind, Antakarana, is established in that Brahma. And that Brahma is Nirdosham. Nirdosham is Samam Brahma. No dosha, no defects can touch that Brahma. See, for example, if I make some pot out of mitti, there might be some defect in that pot. We can say, oh, it is so chota hai, bada hai, shape theek nahi hai, thoda sa crack hai, crack pot hai. But all these defects are of what? Of the pot. But when we look at the clay, we cannot say clay chota hai, bada hai, crack hai. All these defects are not there in the clay. Again, to take example of the ink and the writing. When you read the writing, you might say, oh, this is not a good article. This is very good. There are some grammatical errors are there. Things are not written properly. All this we can tell the defects of the writing. But when our vision is on the ink, there is no defect. Everything is same. Even if you write donkey, and if you write Bhagwan, or if you write good quality, anger or jealousy or love, compassion, with the same ink, if you have the vision on the ink, it is same everywhere. But if you look at the letters, then there is dosha. So dosha is there in the karya. Dosha is not there in the karana. Brahma is the karana of this world. So those who have karana drishti, they are established in that dosha rahit Brahma. But one who has drishti only on the karya, the effect, they see the different dosha. So Bhagavan says, nirdosham hi samam Brahma. So they are established in that nirdosha Brahma. So you cannot call them as having some defect, this atmajnani, by seeing oneness in all. It is not a defect. Tasmat brahmani te stitaha. Since their mind is established in this samatva, they are established in that Brahma alone. हरि व्यापक सर्वत्र समाना, प्रेम ते प्रगट होई मई जाना. अगेन इन रामायण देयर इज दिस इंसिडेंट व्हेन ऑल ऑफ देम, ऑल द देवतास एंड ऑल हैड असेंबल्ड, एंड दे वर थिंकिंग कि डिस्कसिंग कि कहाँ है भगवान, कहाँ है. So some said maybe he is in Vaikuntha, some said aur kahin par. Then Lord Shiva said he is present everywhere. Hari vyapak sarvatra samana. Samana means same everywhere. But he is apragata, dikhai nahi dete hai. Kaise kab dikhai denge? When we have love in our heart. Prem ate pragat hoi mai jana. Prem se pragat ho jate hai. Gyan se pragat ho jate hai. Otherwise he is there everywhere, saman. As much as Bhagwan is there in some Tirthakshetra, he is there in the marketplace, he is there everywhere, same. So nirdosham hi samam brahma, tasmad brahmani te stitaha. So an enlightened person is established in that brahma. He knows that I, the Atma, is brahma and I am same everywhere. Because of this, their response to the whole situation is also different. So how do they respond? It says in the next verse. Na prahrishyet priyam prapya. No dvijet prapya cha priyam. Stira buddhira sammodha. Brahma vid brahmani stitaha. Na prahrishyet priyam prapya. No dvijet prapya cha priyam. Na prahrishyet priyam prapya. They don't get excited by when something dear or something what one likes is gained. Priyam prapya. Having gained something very dear to us, we get excited about it. But an enlightened person doesn't get too excited of having gained something dear. Na udvijet prapya cha apriyam. Nor does he get agitated after gaining something usually which people consider as non-dear. Whatever comes in life, he just accepts it, doesn't get excited about it, nor gets totally dejected by it. Because his attention is on that Brahma. His attention is on that substratum, the very truth. Therefore, there is no disturbance of any kind. So, na prahrishyet priyam prapya, no dvijet prapya cha apriyam. See, for example, if a note is there, 1,000 rupee note in my hand. It is not there, but just imagine. So if you know the value of that note, then suppose I bend it or crush it, still it remains, the value remains same. Value doesn't change. The quality of that note, outer shape and all those things might change, but the value doesn't change. Similarly, the value of this whole world is Brahma. Whatever be the outer quality, outer expression, good, bad, indifferent, it doesn't change the value. That remains same. Brahma is same even when happy situation is there, sad situation is there, something, success is there, failure is there, Brahma is same in all. So their attention is on that Brahma. So na prahrishyet priyam prapya, na udvijet prapya cha apriyam. Stira buddhihi. Why? Because they are stira buddhi. Their buddhi, their understanding about Brahma is completely steady. Stira buddhihi. God, kimcha sarva bhuteshu ekah samah nirdosha atma iti stira nirvichikitsa buddhihi yasya sa stira buddhihi. Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji says that one Brahma is same in all beings, it is samah, it is free from all dosha. This type of understanding is free from all doubts. Therefore, it is called sthira buddhi. What we have seen in the second chapter is sthita prajna. The understanding that I am that Brahma is extremely steady. There is no doubt in it. See, when we are listening to Pravachan, we hear that, oh, I am Brahma. But there is, first of all, there is complete understanding might not be there. Even if that understanding is there, there might be a lot of doubts, question. How can I be Brahma? Because Brahma is the very cause of this world. So how can I be the cause? Because whenever I think of I always think of myself as the body. I am a body is a sthira buddhi for an ignorant person. But I am Brahma is sthira buddhi for a jnani. So sthira buddhihi asammodaha, free from all confusion, free from all doubts, asammodaha brahma vit, the knower of Brahma, brahmani sthitaha, is well established in that Brahma alone. So brahma vit brahmani sthitaha. The nature of this enlightened person is described in all chapters. So in the 12th chapter he is called Bhakta. In the 6th chapter we'll see he is called a Yogi. So in all chapters this enlightened person is described so that we hear the description, we feel inspired to walk this path and attain that state of enlightenment. Further, Bhagavan says, Bahya Sparsheshva Shaktatma Shasakta Vindatyatmani Yatsukham Sabrahma Yoga Yuktatma Sukhamakshayam Ashnute Bahya Sparsheshva Shaktatma Vindatyatmani Yatsukham. He says that how come he is not affected by the happenings of this world, by gaining something conducive, or by not gaining something conducive? How come he is not at all affected? Is because he is experiencing the infinite sukha, happiness of his own self. See, everyone functions in this world in the state of ignorance to acquire some sukha, to acquire some shanti, some peace. So when we come to know that I will get some joy, or I will get some interesting object which will give me joy, that itself makes a person happy. When I come to know that, oh, my friend is coming to meet me, I feel very happy. Then I go to the railway station or airport to pick that person. And I wait there and then I come to know, oh, his flight has arrived. So I feel more happy. So priya, moda, pramoda it is called. So when I come to know about it, I feel little happy, then more happy, then more happy. So everything we do in this world to gain these little joys of this world. But where is the source of all this happiness? The source of this happiness is our own self. It is not in the objects as such, but it is the very nature of the self. And that happiness is gained by this enlightened person. Therefore, bahya sparshesu asaktatma. Such an enlightened person is absolutely free from all attachment to outer objects. Bahya sparsha. Sparsha means those objects which we touch through our senses. See, with our eyes we touch the form and the color. With our ears we touch the sound. So the objects are called that which is touch, sparsha. Jiska sparsha hum karte hai. So when we, our senses come in contact with the sense objects, and if our senses like those sense objects, then we gain some joy. And if we dislike those sense objects, we gain little disturbance or unhappiness. यही हमारा पूरा जीवन में चलते रहता है थोड़ा थोड़ी खुशी थोड़ी गम लाइक नहीं ऑल दिस इज लाइक दैट ओनली बट वन हु इज टोटली फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल अटैचमेंट टू ऑल ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड आउटसाइड बाह्य स्पर्शेषु असक्तात्मा विंदति सच अ पर्सन विंदति सुखम ही गेन्स सुख वेर आत्मनि in the self alone. One who has withdrawn all his attention from the names and forms, from all this outer world, gains the sukha which is present in his own self. This is our everyday experience also. Again, I will refer to our experience of our sleep. I tell you, there is no happiness like sleep. No, really. Everyone doesn't get it every day. Sometimes neend nahi aati hai. Suppose a person is given, is not able to sleep for 4 or 5 days, he will say, Baba, mere ko kuch nahi, paisa chahiye, nahi chahiye, kuch chahiye, nahi chahiye, thoda so leta hun. Just want to sleep. Don't want anything. Children and all during the exam, they keep on studying and keeping awake. If you ask them what you will do in holidays, I will sleep. But unfortunately, they can't sleep. They will be so excited, they will be wide awake. So sleep gives us great joy to everyone. Why? Because our attention gets withdrawn from the world out. Senses get withdrawn and they get packed up into our antakkarana. Our antakkarana also goes into our pranas, somewhere in the nadis they go. And one remains in one's own self. Therefore, there is great happiness. When I wake up, I say I slept so happily. But as soon as I wake up, that happiness seems to just disappear. Because I get distracted by the world, I start again chasing that happiness in the world outside. It is there in me only, but I start chasing it everywhere. They give example of that kasturi mruga, the deer with kasturi. It gets the nice fragrance and it thinks that it must be somewhere there and all. It keeps on looking for it everywhere. Similarly, I experience every day when I go to sleep happiness which doesn't depend on any objects, doesn't depend on any position, name, fame, achievement, nothing. Whether a person is young or old, whatever gender, whatever background, educated, uneducated, rich, poor, everyone who goes to deep sleep gains the same happiness. Why? Because that is the very nature of ourself. But when we are awake, we, out of ignorance, look for that happiness in the world outside. So when we are able to withdraw our attention from all this distraction, we will be able to gain that happiness which is there within us. Atmani bahya sparsheshu asaktatma vindati gains. Atmani yat sukham, he gains that sukha in his own self. स ब्रह्म योग युक्त आत्मा सच योगी सच पर्सन इज टोटली हिज अंतकरण इज टोटली एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन दैट ब्रह्म अलोन. ब्रह्म में ही उनका अंतकरण एज दो विलीन हो गया है. सब ब्रह्म योग युक्त आत्मा सुखम अश्नुते ही इंजॉय दैट सुख. व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सुख? अक्षयम, जिसका क्षय नहीं है. विच डजंट गेट एग्जॉस्टेड, विच डजंट कम टू एन एंड, दैट सुख ही गेन्स. सी व्हेन वी एक्सपीरियंस दैट सुख इन अवर स्लीप, एज सून एज वी वेक अप वी लूज इट बिकॉज वी आर बैक इन टू अ स्टेट ऑफ इग्नोरेंस because of which we look for it elsewhere. But Atmajnani experiences that sukha at all times, akshayam, free, it doesn't get exhausted. So sab brahma yoga yuktatma sukham akshayam asnute. In Taittiriya Upanishad also, those who have heard, we have seen that the different levels of sukha is mentioned there. The greatest sukha a person gains in this world is taken as one unit. A young person having good qualities, good education, senses well under his control, and he is the king of this whole world. So his sukha is taken as one unit. 100 times his sukha is gained by people, those beings of higher loka, like Gandharva and Deva Gandharva and all those beings they get. Indra gets sukha. 100 times Indra's sukha is gained by Brahaspati. 100 times Brahaspati's sukha is gained by Brahmaji. But all the sukha which all these beings gain, a person who is enlightened, who is free from all his attachments, gains here and now only. He doesn't have to go to Swarga for that sukha. He doesn't have to go to Brahmalok for that sukha. It is gained here and now. See, it's like a chocolate with a wrapper. So if one eats the chocolate along with the wrapper, one will experience that happiness, I mean the sweetness, but thoda thoda uska wrapper ka bhi taste aa jayega. So जितना उसको निकालते हैं उतना मिठास ज़्यादा लगती है. सिमिलरली ऑल अवर अटैचमेंट टू अवर बॉडी एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन विद द वर्ल्ड आउटसाइड इज रिड्यूसिंग द हैप्पीनेस ऑफ अवर ओन सेल्फ. द मोर वी विदड्रॉ अवर अटेंशन फ्रॉम ऑल दिस विषय ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड द मोर वी विल बी एबल टू एक्सपीरियंस द जॉय ऑफ द सेल्फ विद इन. Therefore, Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji writes that tasmat bahya vishaya pritehe kshanikaya indriyani nivartayet atmani akshaya sukharthi ityartha. Those who desire the sukha of the self should withdraw their attention from the attachment to the world of objects outside. See, here the teacher is slowly preparing us for meditation now. The next chapter is about meditation. Later on also, this chapter ends with two shlokas which gives the gist of meditation. Meditation is paying attention to our own self, withdrawing all our attention from all other objects and focusing on our own self. So the main distraction for this is our attraction for the world of objects. When a person is meditating, they are distraction, but otherwise also they are distraction. Our attachment to the world of objects. So Bhagavan, in the following verse, he tells us that if we want that param sukha, we have to withdraw. Also, we have to know the defects in our attachment to the world of objects. So it's very beautiful words. He says, ye hi sansparshaja bhogaha दुःखयोनय एवते आद्यन्तवन्तः कौन्तेय नतेषु रमते बुधः ये हि संस्पर्शजा भोगाः दुःखयोनय एव ते He says that ye hi sansparshaja bhogaha. Those bhoga, those enjoyments which are born from our contact with the world of objects. As I said, through our senses we contact the world of objects. The outer world is experienced only through our senses. Only five senses we have. So, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. We experience the world only in this five. Ye sab panch ka chamatkar hai pura jagat. See, just like in our computer, it is all do ka chamatkar hai. Ne? Zero and one or something they say. Vaise, this whole world is just a play of five. All that we see, hear, taste, touch itself is the outer world. So shabda, different types of sound, and that sound also we can hear only in a limited range. Dogs and cats and all can hear more. We can hear only a limited range. Usse aage ka, usse niche ka humko sunai nahi deta hai. So shabda, sparsha. Sparsha also we can experience only maybe little bit. There are some people who can experience finer sparsha also. But otherwise it's very gross like. So shabda, sparsha, rupa, different forms and colors. That also is of a particular range only. Beyond the red, what you call infrared and ultraviolet, I don't think we can see. We can see only that range. So, color, form. So, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, taste. Some six types of taste we can experience. Shabda, sparsha, six types ke taste mein hi pura restaurant chalta hai. And that too, some of the taste are not even used. One or two taste is not even used in. The taste which we get from alum, that is not generally used in our food. So, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa and gandha, different types of fragrance. This itself is the world of these names and forms. So, our senses are born with their own likes and dislikes. Certain forms the eyes may like, certain form the eyes doesn't like. Because it carries the impression from our past lives. We don't know what various types of experiences we had in our past. Even if you go on this past life regression and all, you will not know. All sorts of good and bad experiences which we have had in our past leaves an impression. We might not remember those experiences, but impressions remain. Bachpan may be, whatever you have eaten, whatever fragrance you have had and all, it leaves an impression. You might not remember exactly, but it leaves impression. Because the child, as soon as he's born, he keeps on getting all these things, and that also creates impression. So there are certain impressions which I feel conducive, which I had experienced a positive thing in my past life or sometimes back. So I like those, and certain things I don't like. So indriyasyarthe ragadvesha vyavasthito. Indriya ka indriyon ke arth se ragadvesha hota hai. Certain things I like, certain things I don't like. Okay? So if I come across things, and when I come across something which I like, I feel happy. When there is contact with that object, with my senses, I get that feeling of what we call happiness. Why? Because when the senses come in contact with that object, the mind also becomes little calm and peaceful. The buddhi also becomes calm and peaceful. In that calm and peaceful situation, the joy of my own self is experienced as though thoda shant ho jata hai. Person is very restless. Then he sees bhuke hai kahin jaate hai kisi ke ghar mein. Everyone is sitting outside chatting with you. Khane ke liye bulaya hai. Aur pakane wala koi nahi andar. So we are worried and all. Then वो अंदर जाके तड़का लगा देते हैं तो उसकी जब सुगंध आती है तो इसे हाँ कुछ तो हो रहा है यू फील वेरी हैप्पी एंड दैट इज द सीक्रेट ऑल्सो पहले खाना भी नहीं बना तो तड़का लगा दो फिर धुआं कर दो थोड़ा सो पीपल फील हाँ कुछ हो रहा है आ रहा है सो दिस कंडिसिव टच gives me happiness, non-conducive touch gives me unhappiness. So constantly I try to get conducive touches in this world through my senses. And in this way, I get used to getting happiness only through this touch. I get addicted. People talk about drug addiction and all, but these are all vishaya addiction happens to us. We get addicted to gain that happiness only by interacting with the world of objects. But scripture says that you don't have to depend on those objects for your happiness. Because the happiness comes when the object, you come in contact with the object. But at that time what happens? The mind becomes quiet. At that time what happens? The buddhi is also silent. So you can try to make the mind and buddhi silent, you will experience the same happiness. It is not the objects which is giving you happiness, but it is the quietitude of your mind and intellect which is giving you happiness. So if I can make the mind and intellect quiet, irrespective of the object, then I will not have to depend on them for my happiness. So Bhagavan says, the ehi sansparsha ja bhogaha. What are the defects in this? What is the problem in gaining happiness from the world of objects? He says all this bhoga, that enjoyment which you gain when you contact the world of objects, they are the very source of unhappiness, source of sorrow. Dukkha yonaya evate. Why? Because they have a beginning and they have an end. Means when I am in contact with the object, I feel happy as long as the contact is there. As soon as it is not there, वो happiness चले जाता है. And जब चले जाता है, तो it gives me unhappiness. It gives me sorrow. And the more and more I become dependent on the object, then when I don't get those objects, I become more and more miserable. The misery also becomes more. The intensity of joy which I get when I contact the object, the same intensity of sorrow comes when I withdraw from that object. People become restless, people become dejected, depressed. जो दूसरे addiction में होता है ना वैसा ही होता है. So a person goes into all sorts of depression then. To contact those objects, we have to do so much of jhamela. It depends on so many factors. Sometimes it doesn't depend only on our mehnat. Some people do lot of effort, but still that same condition doesn't come. In our childhood, in our younger days, we have enjoyed something in our village and all. Then they go abroad, they live there for some 10-20 years. But when they come back, they want to go to the same, oh, वो इधर ये वो जलेबी वाला होता था वो कहाँ गया है? ने वो दैट ही डाइड, हिज सन इज नाउ रनिंग द जलेबी थिंग। देन आई गो देयर विथ माई सूटेड बूटेड टाई एंड ऑल, देयर जलेबी ले लेता हूँ हाथ में गरम गरम दूध, एंड आई ट्राई टू गेट द सेम जॉय। समटाइम्स इट डजन कम, नहीं, यू मस्ट हैव ट्राइड। एवरी वन हैज देयर स्पेशल समथिंग। पीपल यू थिंक दे गो टू वाराणसी एंड हरिद्वार ऋषिकेश फॉर दर्शन एंड ऑल, मैनी पीपल गो देयर टू हैव सम लस्सी समवेयर, सम गोलगप्पे समवेयर, सम समथिंग समवेयर। वहाँ पर चोटी वाले का बहुत अच्छा है बाबा, अरे गंगा जी का स्नान करो। नहीं, फर्स्ट यू गो टू चोटी वाला। सो वी वॉन्ट टू रिपीट दोज वी गेट एडिक्टेड टू दैट रस विच वी गेट, सो वी वॉन्ट टू रिपीट। एंड द अनफॉर्चुनेट पार्ट इज दैट यू कैनॉट रिपीट द सेम थिंग ट्वाइस, इट कैनॉट, नो कंडीशन इज रिपीटेड अगेन। थोड़ा सा अलग थोड़ा सा बदलता है, सेम नहीं होता है, बट वी वॉन्ट इट सेम एग्जैक्ट, इट इट डजेंट हैपन। देन वी गेट लेस ऑफ जॉय, देन वी फील मिजरेबल, सर्टन कंडीशंस आर नॉट फुलफील, देन वी फील सैड, देन वी ऑल्सो डोंट नो एग्जैक्टली वॉट गिव मी हैप्पीनेस, इज इट दैट कप ऑफ कॉफी और इज इट दैट सिटिंग नियर द गंगा और इन दैट प्लेस इट गिव मी हैप्पीनेस, बिकॉज आई सिट एंड हैव कॉफी इन माई रूम बट इट डजेंट टेस्ट सेम। देन आई गो टू दैट प्लेस एंड ट्राई टू ड्रिंक बट दैट कॉफी इज नॉट सेम। देन आई गो टू द सेम प्लेस बट द पीपल हु आर सराउंडिंग मी आर नॉट सेम, दे आर इरिटेटिंग पीपल, लास्ट टाइम दे वर डिफरेंट, सो इट बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट। भगवान सेज कि ये ही संस्पर्श जा भोगा दुख योनय एव ते, ऑल दिस भोग विच वन गेन्स थ्रू ऑफ द सेंसेस आर द वेरी सोर्स ऑफ सोरो। वाई दे आर सोर्स ऑफ सोरो? बिकॉज दे आर अद्यंत अद्यंतवंत, दे आर आदि एंड अंतवंत, दे हैव अ बिगिनिंग एंड दे हैव अ एंड, सो इन बिटवीन यू फील द जॉय बट दैट इज अनित्य, सो अनित्य सुखम टेम्पररी हैप्पीनेस। सो वन वो गेट्स इन्वॉल्व इन दिस टेम्पररी हैप्पीनेस विल लूज द परमानेंट हैप्पीनेस ऑफ हिज ओन सेल्फ। सो हे कौन्तेय न तेषु रमते बुधः, अ वाइज पर्सन विल नॉट get involved with this type of happiness. He will not revel in this sensual happiness. He will try to avoid them and try to gain the happiness of his own self. अपने अंदर ही आनंद है। छोटे बच्चे हैं, they are very happy. Why? Because they are more closer to their own self. Their senses have not come out yet. So their whole attention is in their own self only. They are very happy. But as they grow, the senses start going out more and more, and more disturbance starts happening in their life. So adyantavanta kaunteya na teshu ramate buddhaha. Therefore, one should try to control the senses and try to gain that happiness of our own self within. Bhagwan says in the next verse, shakno shakno ti haiva yas sodhum prak sharira vimokshanat kama krodhodbhavam vegam सयुक्तस्य सुखी नरः शक्नोति हैव यः सोढुं प्राक् शरीर विमोक्षणात्। हाँ, भगवान से शक्नोति इह एव, वाइल लिविंग इट्सेल्फ, इफ अ पर्सन इज एबल टू tolerate or bear with what? Kama krododbhavam vegam, with the agitation and the excitement which comes through kama and krodh. If we are able to control this kama and krodh. See, kama means our desires, our craving. Krodha means anger. Bhagavan says about kama, he defines, Shankaracharya ji, ki kama indriya gochara prapte ishte visaye shruyamane smaryamane va anubhute sukaheto ya gardihi trishna sa kamaha. He says that when we hear about the object which had given me happiness in the past, I have experienced something in my past, it had given me great sukha, pleasure. Happiness is pleasure in my past. Then I hear about the same object, or I see that same object, or I, remember that object, then I get intense desire to possess that object. I get intense thirst, craving to acquire that object. That craving, that thirst is called kama. See, like a child is there who has not experienced certain things in life, will be looking at some object, it will not create that craving. But some other person who has experienced it, then he remembers that object, or he sees it, or he hears about it, that craving comes in his heart. And it disturbs that person. So trishna it is called, thirst. So that is kama. And when that kama comes, there is agitation in the whole system. All the senses get agitated, and the body also gets little restless. So that is the vega, that is the force, that power of that kamana. So that makes us fulfill that kamana. But if a person is able to control that, if a person is able to overcome that. See, sometimes the kamana comes out of our past karmas and all, but even when the kamana comes, we should be able to control it. See, for example, just the desire comes in our heart, mind, ki haan, let us go to some place in these holidays. Masuri jayenge. Masuri to pass me, somewhere dur. Switzerland jayenge. We will go there, and the snow, and the ride in the snow, and all those things. So that thought comes in the mind. Then that it creates a lot of pressure inside. Then we discuss at home, what do you think, haan, kitna paisa lagega, kya hai idhar, hai ticket kaisa hai, ye wo. Big discussion happens at home and all. Then more that excitement happens. Then it becomes uncontrollable. If suppose somebody says, nahi, cancel kar dete, to gussa aa jata hai. Cancel to bahut gussa aa jata. So that excitement is called vega, kaam ka vega. Usko jo, for another person, that thought comes, I want to go to Switzerland. He doesn't do anything about it. Wo thought aa jata hai, usko thoda sa aise bol bol ke pareshan ho ke thought jo hai, just dissolves there. He doesn't do anything about it. He bears with it. Once you bear with it for some time, uska jo strength hai, power hai, वो चले जाता है, एंड यू आर एबल टू ओवरकम दैट कामना. सेम थिंग हैपन्स विथ क्रोध. व्हेन अवर कामनास डोंट गेट फुलफिल्ड, इट टर्न्स इनटू क्रोध. और इफ यू रिमेंबर Again, Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji says, krodhascha atmanah pratikuleshu dukkha hetushu drishyamaneshu shruyamaneshu smaryamaneshu va yo dveshah sa krodhah. So that which is unconducive to myself, when I think about that object, which had given me sorrow in the past, when I remember that object, when I see that object, when I hear about it, I get anger in my heart. I feel a little restless. All khoon khaulne lagta hai. Gussa aata jata hai. It's krodha. So one should be able to bear with it. One should be able to tolerate it for some time and it just dies away. So one who can tolerate the vega, that pressure of kama and krodha, Bhagavan says that he is called a yogi. Kama krodhod bhavam vegam sa yuktaha, yuktaha yogi, and sa sukhi naraha. And he says he is really happy person. That person is a happy person. That person is really happy. That person has now started his journey within. See, people at home, people in the world who are used to this fulfilling kamna and all, they will not like that fellow. They say, isme to kuch nahi, kuch itni humne plan kiya to unhone us pe pani dal diya. Some people are very good in planning and all. Aise karenge, waise karenge, waise karenge. And you say, kya karenge, baith ke dekhte hai, TV pe dekhte hai, Switzerland. He will go to the market and bring one CD on Switzerland. Dekhe beto, chai pite pite dekho, chahe to AC full kar leta hu main, so that you can experience that. People don't like such people. They say, yeah, isme koi ras nahi, kuch nahi, kuch nahi, bekar ka. But really speaking, that person is starting his journey within. Because the real joy, sukha, Bhagavan says, sa sukhi na raha. Wahi sukhi hai. Vaki wo dukhi hai. Itna maar peet karke, yahan vahan ghumke, and all, after doing all things, he will experience sorrow only. As long as you are in contact with that, you will have that joy. But once that is over, it will just remain in the memory to give more agitation in future, and the joy will also end, giving rise to sorrow. So shaknoti iha eva yas sodhum. So yaha, while alive itself, praksharira vimokshanat, Bhagavan says, before you die, means till the end, till we die, one should not rely on this kama and krodha. One should not be confident that, oh, I have conquered my mind. Till one dies, one should put forth effort to conquer this vega of kama and krodha. Because when it will come, because it is coming because of past karmas only. So when it will come, sometimes it comes at the last minute. People have become old and all, still some kamna comes and they take certain decisions in life which after hearing that people are shocked. So till the end of our life, one should be very alert and control this vega of kama and krodha. If one is able to do, Bhagavan says he is a yogi and he is the real sukhi person, and he will be able to ultimately realize his own self. So some practical guidance is given here. More about this we will see tomorrow. Oh. पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ॐ।